You don't believe Jesus is God, right?
You know, when you raised in a Baptist or an African Methodist church, yeah, and those things have been taught to you all those years.
I feel you.
But, you know, as you get older, you start to question things.
Right.
You know, especially with the internet and all these manuscripts that are coming out. And,
exactly.
You know, that you start
exactly.
to question. So, you know.
If you look in the Bible, for example, even with the corruptions and all that, right, you will find that in Exodus 4:22, it says, "Then you shall say to Pharaoh, thus says the Lord, Israel is my son, my firstborn." So you see, Israel, which is Jacob, Yaqub, is called the firstborn son of God here, right? But they don't take him. They're like, "Oh, that's just a figure of speech," right? You keep going.
I've never heard that verse before.
See, that's the thing. All them preachers, they hide these verses. Look right here. 2 Samuel 7:13-14. "He shall build a house for my name, and I will establish the throne of his kingdom forever. I will be his father, and he shall be my son." This is about Solomon. Mm-hmm. Old Testament. Mm-hmm. Right? Solomon is called the son. Let's look at David. You have the Psalms of David. Psalms 2, verse 7. "I will declare the decree. David is saying, "I will declare the decree. Right. The Lord has said to me, you are my son. Today I have begotten you." Yeah. Right? Go home and look at this, right? Now what happens is, you got Ephraim, the son of God. You got Adam being called the son of God. All of those Christians will be like, "You know what? That's a metaphor. That's just a statement." Even though David is saying that the Lord said to me that I have begotten you. Oh, that's just a term in Hebrew. But when it came to Jesus, they try to mix it up.
Well, there's also a verse here, and I don't remember where it was. It tells a story, and then it says, "And this too is an allegory," which means it's a lie.
Exactly.
So I'm like,
oh, and there are there, you know? There are many verses, even in the New Testament, that clearly show that we don't even know who wrote these books. Right? I mean, I'll give you an example, right? This is a study Bible, right? A study, this is a Christian evangelical preacher Bible something study Bible, right? And this is what they prepare their preachers with, right? If you go to Hebrews, it says the author of Hebrews is unknown. We don't even know who wrote these. How are we going to say this is the word of God, right?
Now, what about all these scrolls they find, like the Dead Sea Scrolls,
right,
and they end up in the Bible? Where does that fit into this?
So those Dead Sea Scrolls are for the Old Testament, and many of those still contradict what we find printed in the Old Testament. Many have not even been, parts of those have not even been released yet. The Israeli government's holding them, right? Those are all Old Testament and earlier texts. None of those are even from the time of Moses, peace be upon him. None of them are from the time of Jesus, peace be upon him. Those are all written by people we don't know, right? What we have is the final messenger message preserved and authorized to be the final message till the day of judgment, right? So anything in those earlier texts, we judge them by the final text. But look, this is something that's between you and you don't even have to bring this up right now, right? This is something that you already have in your heart. You're already a Muslim. You already believe in Allah. You already believe in the prophets. You've already seen the deceptions of the Bible. You've already seen the truth of the Quran, the preservation of the Quran. This is between you and Allah, not anybody else, right? Have a conversation, but don't let it drag on. The shaitan, he likes to procrastinate, you know? You feel me?
Yeah. Well, thank you guys very much.
Appreciate it, brother. All right, we'll be waiting. We've got your number. We'll keep in touch.